Welcome to Watch Me Go Broke. I like great watches, fast cars, and fast women. Well, not too fast. I want to be able to catch them. But alas, I'm married. So all of those fun things go right out the window. But what if I told you there was a watch that you could sneak under your wife's radar? It's got great specs, and it's only $65. Let's awkwardly bend over a table and take a look. Okay, so it's a little rainy outside today, so I've taken the proper precaution, and I am wearing my Phoebus Ocean Master 1,000-meter diver. You guys always want to wear your 1,000-meter divers out in the rain. You know, you can never be too careful. LOL. If you're going to have a go at one of these, you could pick one up on eBay for as little as $65. This particular listing has two different colors, black and the green. I know they also make a two-tone and a blue version. All right, so here is the box that it comes in. Let's flip around open and see what you got. An instruction manual that's going to tell you how to operate the watch, I'm assuming. Ah, yes. Bunch of stuff that doesn't pertain to this particular watch. International guarantee card here that is not filled out, so that is also probably useless. Nice microfiber cloth. That's a nice touch to include that. And there is the watch. So we've got a 43 millimeter case, a thickness of 13 millimeters, a lug to lug of 52 millimeters. We've got a sapphire crystal, which at this price point, really cool. A Cyclops that does 2.5 times magnification, as it should if you're ever going to use a Cyclops. We've got 22 millimeter lugs tapering down a bit and back up to the clasp. The clasp, this is not the clasp that comes on the watch. I'll explain that in just a bit. And we've got a display case back displaying the Seiko NH35 movement. There is a 120 click unidirectional bezel. The bezel action is actually pretty good. It's pretty satisfying. There is a decent amount of back play, and it actually will, if you kind of jiggle it a little bit, it seems somewhat loose, but the action on it is pretty good. You've got the Pagani Design logo on the dial, and then automatic water-resistant 10 bar/100 meters. Now, this is obviously an homage to the Rolex Hulk Submariner, and it actually gets it pretty close, which I don't know if that's concerning or really awesome. And the reason I say it's concerning is because this is so close and it's only $65. I don't even know how they do that at this price. The NH35 movement itself, if you're going to purchase it off eBay or from a reputable dealer, it's around $40 itself. So then you're looking at, even to build this watch yourself, it would be way more expensive than just buying this. You've got Mercedes-style hands with the lollipop seconds hand. All applied indices that do have some loom. I can throw up a loom shot towards the end of the video. The loom is really not good. It doesn't hang on at all. The hands hang on pretty good, but we'll show you. Now, this is the clasp that it comes with. And the clasp is not bad. It's actually a pretty decent clasp. It's a nod to the Submariner Oyster style clasp. It doesn't have any micro adjustments, and that's the main reason that I switched it out. It doesn't have any sort of glide lock inspired adjustments or anything like that. But I went with this clasp, and this clasp is I think it was off a Parnas watch that I got, and it is a Sea Dweller, a deep sea style. Ooh, got my glove caught. Good Lord. Oh, I almost lost my finger. Did you see that? Ooh. It's a Sea Dweller, deep sea style clasp, which means it has this adjustment to where you can slide in and out that way, and a diver's extension. I felt like this clasp suited this watch more because you're looking at a 43 millimeter watch, and the deep sea, I believe, is 44 millimeters. So you're very much in a larger watch category than you would be with the regular Hulk Submariner or the regular Submariner. The bracelet has screw links, and I've had to take all of them out. that could be adjusted in order to fit this different style clasp. I don't know if that's something you'll have to do. I have a 7 1/4 inch wrist, so that really isn't a lot of adjustment for maybe somebody that has an 8 inch wrist. Not sure if that will actually fit you or not. So what do I like about this watch? Well, obviously, I like the price. $65, and you're getting a ceramic bezel, a sapphire crystal, a stainless steel case, screw-down crown, NH35 movement, a solid N-link, screw-link bracelet with a pretty decent clasp, all for $65. Kind of hard to complain about anything. And what do I not like? Well, there's not a whole lot to not like about this. One thing I don't like, the lollipop seconds hand. This is one of my pet peeves that I just absolutely cannot stand. You gotta pick the right distance for the lollipop. You need to either have it all the way to the end or back far enough to where you have a good extension of the end of the seconds hand. This is kind of in between those, and I just don't think it looks right. I think it looks like they messed up or something along those lines. So that I don't like. I'd like to see in the future an adjustment on that. What I also don't like is the size. Oh, you were so close, Pagani. So close. If you had made this in a 40 millimeter, we probably could have all quit doing reviews of. I mean, I'm not sure why you went closer to the Sea Dweller size than you did to the Submariner size. I mean, just go all in. I mean, you've literally put 99.9% of everything that the watch that you're homaging has in it. Why not just go that extra 0.1% with the seconds hand and the size? But that's really the only thing to complain about on this watch. I mean, the value for money, it's unbelievable. I mean, you should just go get it. Immediately. And there it is on my 7 1/4 inch wrist. It does wear big due to the lug to lug for sure. 40 millimeters would have been perfect for this watch, but hey, at $65, who's gonna be complaining? Well, there you go, the PD1639. A great watch. They just adjust that seconds hand, make the case size about 3 millimeters shorter. I think you got yourself a great watch. So until next time, I'll catch you at the finish line.